break Nate, bitch, I'm solid as steel. Break the home, catch a case, we gon' file an appeal. Got a vibe with the heat, cause my diamonds is chill.
I got it on
my jewels, boy, you must be trying to get killed. Real tote bag, red bottom or heels. Got them wondering if Young Woo sign him a deal.
On YouTube, it's your boy Young Woo back with some Mo on the Block news, man. Make sure y'all hit that like, hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell. Not later, but right now. Tap into the links in my description, my website, order some clothes, physical copies of my music, and I accept donations. But listen, man, I'm still on this PNB Rock topic, right? So I was just thinking about it, like, I should make a video and paint some scenes since I'm an LA nigga and I'm the perfect man, you feel me, to paint the image out for y'all. Let me give y'all some scenarios of what could have happened or things that could have happened to PNB Rock. All right, PNB Rock, pull up. Some niggas could have spotted him. Soon as he got out, laid on him, watch him going to Roscoe's, like boom. While nigga make sure he keep on watching the Roscoe's, he already made the call to his homies, so his homies on their way. Niggas be on standby, right? Could have played out that way. Could have played out like this. Somebody in a restaurant eating right next to him. Nigga, I'm eating right across from. Could have sent the text out. I'm sitting right next to PNB Rock. He eating right here with his family. It looked like he lacking. Come get this nigga shit. Right? It could have played out like that. It also could have played out like this. This is what y'all not placing the blame on. The motherfucking employees, nigga. You forgot they broke too? You forgot they broke. You heard the name Roscoe's and forgot the damn employees ain't got no money either. Nigga, they serving the rapper, nigga. On my mama, they serving the rapper, nigga. They working in this famous place, nigga. This the brand, nigga. They just the employees. So think about all the criminals or the niggas who could commit crime that don't get caught. On my mama, niggas got jobs, fool. Niggas got jobs. So any nigga in LA could have been a part of PNB Rock getting robbed, you feel me? They could have sent the text out, nigga. The chef could have sent the text out, nigga. What your niggas talking about?
It's really like so many ways the shit could have played out, though. It's crazy. Like, you feel me? Motherfucker could have just been doing it on no spiteful shit, posting a nigga. This nigga PNB Rock at the Roscoe's pumped up bragging about it, you feel me? But the whole world able to see it, you feel me? There's many ways for it to play out, but I'm gonna tell you what doesn't make sense. Why would the baby mama want the baby daddy dead when, I mean, he not a deadbeat, you feel me? Nigga, who give a fuck about the chain? Nigga, he probably just spent however much that chain is worth on her, nigga. Why would she want the nigga gone? Why would she risk his life to get a damn chain when she lay with the nigga with the chain every night? Lay with the nigga with the jewels every night. You feel me? Probably was fucking with her before he got the jewels. How do y'all sound, bro? What benefit that has for her? To help some other niggas get some bum ass niggas with no money get a motherfucking chain from your baby daddy that's rich as fuck? And take his life so he be taken away from you? Like, nah, that don't look like they hated each other, nigga. That don't even make sense. See, this the thing about vlogs from, I ain't even gonna say where they from, because some vlogs, you feel me, they be popping that real shit no matter where they from. But some vlogs just be putting out bullshit, bro. Like, talking about, like, it don't make sense because, all right, the girlfriend probably posted a plate at Roscoe's, but they said minutes after she posted the plate at Roscoe's, the niggas came in and killed him. Like, come on, bro. Like, that fast, my nigga? That fast? That shit don't make no sense, fully. That shit don't make no sense, but I just want to say rest in peace to PNB Rock. I'm going to just say this. Nigga, the manager might have something to do with the PNB Rock murder. We really don't know. The manager probably was an old gang member back in the day who got some young killers ready to ride for him right now. We really don't know. But as far as the baby mama, his girlfriend, nigga, setting him up? Nah, that don't make sense, fool. Why would she want to take her child's father away from her? You feel me? Like, think about that. He is the bag, and he spends the bag on her. So what can a bum-ass nigga say to a broad with a rich nigga, you feel me, that do everything for her? What can a bum-ass, broke-ass nigga say to a female to make her set up her rich boyfriend, bro? Think about that shit. When he's splurging on her, he's spending on her. That's probably his car she driving. He probably paying for the meal. And your bum ass nigga trying to hit a lick. Think about that shit, my nigga. LA crazy as a motherfucker. Okay, this will be not mentioning also, you feel me? Y'all know how record labels work. They be having life insurance plans out on the artists. You feel me? So
They could have been laying on him for the longest, nigga. As soon as they seen opportunity, like, this nigga in the hood right now. Ooh, we got him. They ain't gonna know who did it. They gonna place the blame on the gangs anyway. We got him. So what happens when an artist that just left a label passes away, right? What happens? Well, Academics told us it's like a break period to where they can actually release music. So that means the only music that the fans are gonna play right now is the catalog that the label owns. So the label owns a lot of PNB Rock's catalog, right? So when he passes away, the songs that they own shoot up to the top, and they make millions and billions of dollars off the shit. Selfish is number one on Apple Music right now. You feel me? So I believe, you feel me, that's probably the part we damn sure missing. The labels. Just think about all these artists that after they leave a label or once they sign to a label, they pass away right after. PNB Rock just did an interview talking about how the labels was taking his money and how he wasn't seeing every dollar he posted to. He like, all right, we're going to do it like this. And then they got it worked out. As soon as they let him free, he thought he was free. And they came and they set him up to get killed. And they took the chain. They took his trophy so his family couldn't have nothing. Couldn't have nothing to hold on to his likeness. Not even his jewelry. That's how the government play. That's how these record labels play. So the next time a motherfucker asks me, Young Woo, when you gonna get a record deal? Nigga, I'm not signing my soul away, nigga. I'm not signing away my publishing, my masters, nigga. These royalties is for me and my family, nigga. On the real, if I go today, my family gonna eat. Nigga, my songs, nigga, make my videos, nigga, make my songs number one, nigga, so my family can get every dollar. Cause that's what's gonna happen with me. Cause I ain't signing away nothing. There's no dollar amount. Like, nah. If I gotta sign away everything I own to get rich, I don't need to be rich. You feel me? Because everything I own gonna get my family rich if something happened to me today. You feel me? And get life insurance on yourself, man, so your family can eat, bro, when you gone. You feel me? And prepare your family and teach them how to eat without you, bro, because you ain't gonna be here forever. None of us are, my nigga. We gotta pass down the generational wealth, the generational education. I just wanna say this, you feel me? This is a very unfortunate situation that happened to PNB Rock. And it's also a lesson that can be learned in this shit, you feel me? Because everything that happens around the world, every story, I try to take a lesson up out of it. LA is so motherfucking dangerous, bro. Like, you feel me? I'm a forward thinker, right? You feel me? Because they say that, like, the rich and the wealthy people, I know I'm not rich and wealthy yet, but a nigga trying to be like them, trying to get on their level, right? So the rich and wealthy, they worry the most when things is going good. You feel me? So when shit was going good, like I'm talking about everybody having dollars and shit, I was kind of like, I was thinking about the future. I'm like, how motherfuckers gonna act once they spend all their money? How motherfuckers gonna act when the money gone? Like, what niggas gonna be doing 2 years from now? Is niggas gonna have money 2 years from now? You feel me? I was already thinking about the effects that it'll have on the community, and we starting to see it. You feel me? So, like, we gotta protect our valuables. You feel me? We gotta know how to step outside. We gotta know how flashy to be, how flashy we can be, how flashy we can't be. We gotta be aware and alert on the places we pull up to. We gotta know about the areas and understand checking in, man. Checking in. It's not the word checking in sound bad. Just tap in with your peoples, man. You know somebody in LA in the city, tap in with them. Like, hey, what's the deal for them in the city? You feel me? I know you probably busy with your fam, but a nigga, me and wifey, we trying to go get some good to eat. You feel me? A nigga ain't trying to be caught lacking. Nigga ain't trying to get caught slipping. So what's the good areas I should go to? You feel me? And your real rap friends, your real celebrity friends, they know LA. They could tell you. You feel me? Or the people that ain't celebrities, your LA friends, they could tell you where it's safe at, where you can and where you can't go. So that's what checking in is. You feel me? I call it tapping in. Tap in with me. You feel me? I'll let you know. But, man, as far as that jewelry, man, that flashy shit, man, listen, I love jewelry. I love jewelry, but I love my life too. You feel me? And it just seemed like, damn, like, a nigga can't have shit in LA right now. Nigga can't have shit. Niggas want to kill you for what you got, my nigga. Niggas want to take what you work hard for, nigga, and put it in their possession, nigga. Oh, my mama, niggas want to take your possessions and make it theirs. So, man, hey, if you're going to be moving with all the jewelry, make sure you moving on some Call of Duty, you feel me?
on my mama, that's the best way to say it. If you gonna move with all the jewelry, make sure you move with Call of Duty. You feel me? Militant, nigga. On my mama. And you ain't gotta go place by yourself, nigga. Get some security. And if you ain't got no security, nigga, that's what they said. If you ain't willing to die about it, don't wear it. You feel me? If you wanna die with your jewelry, go ahead. Wear that shit freely. I used to always wonder, I'm like, damn, I see a lot of niggas be wearing their jewelry and shit all out everywhere. Why I'm not like that? Why do I feel like not comfortable just wearing my shit anywhere, just going anywhere with my shit, wearing my shit 24/7? Why do I not trust people? And this why, my nigga, I don't trust nobody. Especially don't trust nobody who ain't getting no money. You feel me? So that's what be your mindset when you go into the hood. You can love the hood all you want, but it's a lot of motherfuckers ain't getting no money. It's a lot of niggas ain't trying to do nothing but bullshit. You feel me? You want to stay away from those people. Like Kevin Gates said, if you need a gun, when you go there, you don't need to go there. You feel me? But let me know what y'all think in the comments, man. Hit that like, hit that subscribe button. Hit the notification bell, man. Not later, but right now. My name is Young Woo. This is On The Block News.
Fuck with me. Nope. I done served 100 real. I be with a money be flying over other seas. Truth is, I got more love when I was broke. Real shit. Now I got money, seem like niggas want to smoke. We all wanted bad bitches wanna fuck me cause I'm dope. Tryna fuck. All I see is green getting bundles with the lokes. I can't let a broke boy trick me off the street. Hell remember, no. I was homeless, now you rent up on my feet. What you spent in a year, I just spent it in a week. I still hungry, chasing meals, showing niggas how to eat. Real street nigga, I ain't trying to play gangster. No. Young go get it, I just wanna make paper. It ain't safe, but with my Glock, I feel way safer. And it came with a drum like a bass player. Fuck getting ready, always ready for combat. Can't tell I got it on me, reason I love a compact. No. I can't sign a deal unless it's millions in the contract. No. Money on your head, then them killers put your top back. Young boss nigga, woo to your peons. Better run like Ricky when we dumping out the Nissan. Bring the money straight to the block like King. Ice on my neck be shining harder than neon. Niggas wasn't moving right, now they left out. Ain't nobody crossing me, they getting X'd out. Chest out. If you ask me, I'm the best out. Who got more money, me or you? Nigga, let's count. Rocky little dude, I be rocking all my jewels. Put it in my hand and the product getting moved. When we catch them, stretch them, put his potters on the news. Isn't it ironic how we talked about the school? Right there. On the block like I'm serving crack. Yeah. Niggas better not speak on Young Woo, I heard he scrapped. Everybody acting like they killers, that's just murder cap. Niggas pulling packs, turn track star when burners clap. Will Smith a nigga hit him with the Ike Turner slap. These niggas can't really rap, all they verses whack. Presidential rollie on my wrist, cost like 30 racks. I ain't never tripping or spinning cause I'ma earn it back. Yeah, I'm a real project baby from PB, nigga. Heard you hit the bounty jail and went PC, nigga. While I was looking like a star on your TV, nigga. You probably mad I'm signing hard with these VVs, nigga. Look, I was trying to put niggas on but they had other plans. Talking about who's tougher but I don't understand. Roddy Richer, nigga, have you ever touched 100 bands? Stack it up and blow it, man, don't run it up again. Roddy Richer, nigga, have you ever touched 100 bands?
Huh?
What? Nigga, Roddy Richer, nigga, have you ever touched 100 bands?
Huh?
Yeah, nigga, I'm the fucking man. Roddy Richer, nigga, have you ever touched 100 bands? Tell me, nigga, huh?
Can't hear you, nigga. Speak up.
Roddy Richer, nigga, have you ever touched 100 bands?
Never seen it, nigga.
Huh?
Have you ever touched, nigga?
Roddy Richer, nigga, have you ever touched 100 bands?
I let the money talk for me, young nigga.
Roddy Richer, nigga, have you ever touched 100 bands?
Huh?
Nigga,
how you seen it before, nigga?